Good morning, everyone. Let us start this session. So in this session, we will start with the dynamics part of the engineering mechanics. So this is the section 2 of your subject. So engineering mechanics subject is divided into two parts. The first is the engineering static and second is the engineering dynamics. Okay. So what is basically dynamics? So dynamics, so it is the branch of engineering mechanics. Which deals with the motion analysis along with the forces which causes that motion. So dynamics, it is the branch of mechanics. So mechanics subject, it is subdivided into two parts. The first is statics and second is the dynamics. Okay, so static, it deals with the force analysis when the object is stationary, that is, there is no motion. And in the dynamics, we'll deal with the objects which are in the motion. Okay, so basically dynamics, it is the study of the motion. Okay, so what is exactly motion? So motion is defined with different parameters. So the common parameter to describe the motion, it is the velocity. So when object is moving, it will have some velocity. Okay, second parameter in the motion, it will be acceleration. That means if the object is in motion and its velocity is continuously increasing or it is decreasing, then it will have some acceleration. So this is the V and this is the acceleration A. Then third parameter to describe the motion. So it is the displacement. Okay, so displacement means when object is moving from one point to other point. Okay. So that will be called as a displacement. The next parameter in the motion, it is the time. So how much time has been taken by a particular object or a particle, okay, to cover a particular distance. So motion is defined by these parameters. So these are called as a motion parameters. Okay. So we will deal with all these parameters when we will study the motion of a particular object or a particle. In the dynamics, along with this motion, sometimes we will deal with the forces which causes that motion. Okay. So this complete analysis of the motion along with the forces is called as a dynamics part. Okay. So this dynamics is again divided into two parts. The first part in the dynamics, it is called as a kinematics. And second part is called as a kinetics. So kinematics, it only deals with the motion. So it deals with the motion analysis without considering the forces. So So this is called as a kinematics part, okay? And the kinetic part, it deals with the motion analysis. By considering the forces which causes that motion. Okay. So in kinematics part, we will use the equations of motions. So what are the equations of motions? So kinematics part, it uses the equations of motion. Okay. So these equations are, these are the well-known equations. V is equal to U plus AT. Then AC is equal to UT plus half AT square. And V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. So by using these equations, we will do the motion analysis. And in the kinetics part, along with these equations, we will consider the forces. So in the kinetics part, we will use the motion equations. And plus, we will use the equations which will consider the forces. So what are those equations? We will use Newton's second law. Okay, so in the Newton's second law, the basic equation is F is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, so this equation, it combines the use of force and use of the motion parameter, that is the acceleration. Okay, so this is called as a kinetics part. So now we will start with the first part of the dynamics, that is the kinematics. Okay, so I hope this difference is clear. What is meaning of dynamics and what is the difference between kinematics and kinetics? So kinematics is the motion analysis without considering the forces, and kinetics is the motion analysis by considering the forces. So if you refer your syllabus, then from fourth module, this is the dynamics part. Okay. So in the dynamics, the first module, which is the module number 4, this is the kinematics of particle. Okay. So kinematics of particle. So we will consider a complete object as a particle. Okay. So we will not be interested in its size and the shape. Then fifth module, it is the kinematics of the rigid body. Okay. So difference between particle and the rigid body is, in the kinematics of particle, we will deal with the motion analysis of the object, where the size and shape of the object, it will not matter. Okay. So we'll consider suppose we have the car. Okay. Then we consider the car as a particle only. Its shape and size will not matter, okay, for the force analysis or the motion analysis. And in the fifth module, that is the kinematics of particle rigid body, we are interested in the shape and the size of the object. Okay, so now we will start with the module number 4, which is the kinematics of particle. So this is the content of the module number 4: the motion of the particle with the variable acceleration. Okay, so we will deal with the motion analysis, where the acceleration will be changing. Then we will study the general curvilinear motion. Then we will find out the tangential and the normal component of the acceleration, okay, for the curvilinear motion. Then motion analysis with the help of the curves. So this is called as a graphical analysis. So where we will plot the acceleration time graph, velocity time graph, and displacement time graph. Then we will study the projectile motion. So, and the numericals related to the projectile motion. Okay. Okay, so in the kinematics of particle, we will deal with only with the motion analysis. So for the motion analysis, we will require the equations of motion. So first equation is V is equal to U plus AT. Then S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Okay. So V is the final velocity. U is the initial velocity. Then A is the acceleration. T, it is the time for that motion. And S is the displacement. Okay. So we will find out the equation for velocity, acceleration. Okay. So first we will discuss about the displacement. So what is displacement? So suppose a car is moving along a straight path. Okay. So initially this car is at the position 1 and it travels along the positive x direction and it reaches to the position 2. Okay. So the displacement for this car will be, suppose we represent this as a x1 and this as a x2 along the positive x direction. Okay. So this is called as a displacement. So this displacement we can write, it is the difference between the final position and the initial position. Okay. So displacement is the difference between final position of the particle and the initial position. So for this example, the displacement S is represented as x2 minus x1. So for an example, if x1, this is equal to 2 meter with respect to the origin, okay, and this x2, it is equal to 6 meters. So the displacement of that particle or the car, it will be 6 minus 2, that is equal to 4 meters. Okay, then the velocity so its definition is, it is a rate of change of displacement with respect to time. Okay. So mathematically, velocity, it is written as V is equal to, it is ds by dt. Okay. So this is the vector quantity V bar. Okay. So ds by dt. So what is meaning of ds by dt? So right now displacement, this is equal to 6 meter. And suppose the time taken. So initially, this time is 0. That means it is the starting point of the motion. Okay. When the car is at the position 1 or it is at the x1. Okay. So to cover this distance, the time taken, suppose at x2, time is 4 seconds. Okay. So this is the t2 and this will become t1. So t1 is 0 and t2 is 4. So displacement is 6 meter. And this change in time, this is equal to t2 minus t1. that is equal to 4 seconds. Okay, so this is equal to 3/2. So this is 1.5 meter per second. So this is the velocity. It is ds by dt or dx by dt. So simple equation for the velocity, v is equal to s upon t, or sometimes it is written as a dx by dt. So s here represent the displacement, and dx by dt, it represent the change in position. Okay, so dx means it will become x2 minus x1. So this is the dx, and t2 minus t1, so this is the dt. Okay, then acceleration, this is the rate of change of velocity. So with respect to time, so mathematical acceleration is given by dv upon dt. Okay, so suppose the car is moving with some initial velocity, let us take this as a 2 meter per second. Okay, so this velocity, this is the u, or we can take this value as a v1. Okay, after some time its velocity changes, and this velocity v2, or it is taken as the final velocity v, it becomes 6 meter per second. Okay, and the time taken to achieve this velocity of 6 meter per second, this is 2 seconds. So within 2 seconds, velocity changes from 2 meter per second to 6 meter per second. Okay, so acceleration, we can write this dv means it is v2 minus v1, and this dt, it is nothing but the t2 minus t1. Okay, so v2 minus v1, it will become 6 minus 2, and this is 2 seconds, that is the t2 minus t1. Okay, so this is equal to 4/2, that is equal to 2 meter per second square. Okay, so this is how we can find out the acceleration. So the equations for velocity, v is equal to dx by dt, and acceleration, it is equal to dv by dt, or we can write this acceleration as, if you replace velocity by dx by dt, then we will have, it is a d by dt, and velocity is dx by dt. Okay, so it will become d2x upon dt square. So it becomes second order differential equation. Okay, so these are some formulae that we will require when we will do the motion analysis for the given object. So now we will study the rectilinear motion. So motion of the particle is divided into two main categories. One is the rectilinear motion, and second is the curvilinear motion. So rectilinear motion means it is the motion along a straight path or a straight line. So motion of the particle or the object along a straight path, this is called as a rectilinear motion. So for rectilinear motion, we will use all equations of motion to analyze the motion. So we will understand this rectilinear motion with the help of one example. So a particle, it travels along a straight line. Such that in 4 seconds, it moves from an initial position which is represented as SA, which is minus 8 meters. So this is the initial position, to second position SB, which is plus 3 meters. Okay, then in another 5 seconds, it moves from SB to SC. So SC, this is minus 6 meters. Determine the particle's average velocity and the average speed during the 9 second interval. Okay, so the question given is a particle travels along a straight line such that in 4 seconds it moves from the initial position SA, which is minus 8 meters, okay, to SB plus 3 meters. So let us understand the position along this straight path. Okay, so this is the path. So on this path, particle initially at this position, which is SA, that is a minus 8 meters. So minus 8 meters, it is with respect to the origin. So we have to consider the origin. So this is the origin. It will have the coordinates as a 0. So this position is minus 8 meters. That is 8 meters along the negative x side. So from SA to SB, so this is the plus 3 meters. So this is the SB position. Okay. So for this journey, from SA to SB, it takes the time as a 4 seconds. Then in another 5 seconds, it moves from the SB to SC. So from SB, it moves to SC, which is minus 6 meters. So minus 6 will be somewhere here. So this is the SC, and this is equal to 6 meters. With respect to origin on the negative x side. And for this journey, so basically it is a return journey. The time taken, this is 5 seconds. Okay. So question is, determine particle's average velocity and the average speed during the 9 seconds of journey. Okay. So what is velocity and the average speed? So average velocity, it is represented as final displacement minus the initial displacement divided by the time interval. Okay, sorry, this is final position. So final position of the particle divided by the initial minus initial position and divided by time interval. Okay, so if you refer the positions, so initially particle as at the position 8 meter on the negative x side, so position SA, this is equal to minus 8 meter. Okay. And the final position, this is equal to minus 6 meter. Okay, because particle travels from SA to SB, this is the first motion. In the second motion, it travels from SB to SC, so finally it reaches to a position minus 6 meter. Okay, so if you refer this formula, then final position, this is minus 6 meter minus initial position is minus 8 meter divided by. So what is the time interval between final and the initial position? So we have to add all the time. So first journey, it takes 4 seconds. Okay. And for the next journey, it takes the 5 seconds. So total time is 9 seconds. So this is divided by the 9. Okay. So it will become 2/9, and that is equal to 0.22 meter per second. So this is the average velocity. Okay. Now we have to find out the average speed. So formula to find out the average speed is the total distance traveled divided by the time taken. Okay, so total distance traveled means what? First distance is SA to SB. Okay, then next will be SB to SC. So from SA to SB, distance is 8 + 3, that is equal to 11 meter. Okay. And from SB to SC, distance will be 3 + 6, that is equal to 9 meter. Okay. So total distance traveled, it will be 8 + 3 + 3 + 6, and divided by total time is same, that is equal to 9. So this is equal to 20/9. So this is 2.22 meter per second. Okay, so this is the difference between average velocity and the average speed. So average velocity is net displacement divided by the time interval. Okay, so final position minus initial position means it is the net displacement. So this is net displacement divided by the total time. And the average speed is total distance traveled divided by the time. Okay.